Hi, Jeannie.
Hi.
So, this is our final episode of the season. We're wrapping.
Mm-hmm. We are.
We've had a good season. We've had a lot
of...
We've had a really well-rounded group of people to come in. And we still have so many more people to have on and issues to talk about because planning a wedding goes deep. There's a lot of different levels to it.
Yeah. So, and such a big thank you to our production team, too, for getting, you know, all of our guests together and getting, you know, and getting everybody on. And
oh, my goodness.
It was really cool to kind of get like different perspectives from all different avenues of the industry. So that's been really awesome.
Okay. Well, those that are listening, when we started this podcast, you'll probably notice anyone who's tuning in and seeing us on video, like a video podcast, those started halfway through the season. So we started recording while we were still at our Jersey City office around this tiny little table in this tiny little room because it was quiet. So we set it up like a sound room and, you know, there were six of us packed into this tiny little closet type of space.
Yeah, and I remember feeling really claustrophobic.
It was claustrophobic. And then we would take like breathers going out and just getting fresh air. Do you remember?
Yes.
So we got through a good amount of episodes. And then this all hell broke loose with the pandemic. And so everybody was put on a stay-at-home order, scrambling. Do we leave the house? Do we not? How are we going to eat? Is there ever going to be toilet paper again? You know, we were in like this, the world is over as we know it. And,
you know, I just want to say something about this toilet paper thing. Like that, I think that left me the most confused with this whole pandemic. I mean, just stick your butt in a shower, right? At
you
the end of the day,
that,
if you ran
you
out
have
of
said that the entire time. And I've told
I don't
everyone
get it.
You said that.
No, but it's true. Like, I mean, look, at the end of the day, you know, we'd love to have toilet paper, but if you run out, we still have a shower.
That's right. And I'm still going through like the massive from Costco, like the massive box of toilet paper. That's not my normal brand. So it's like, so we have to get through it, you know? But anyway, so it put us in this place where we were halfway through a season. And do you continue with the guests that we had lined up or do you, you know, do you stop? And how are we going to continue because we can't see each other and we're all set up at the office? So our production team was amazing. They got it together and they packaged microphones for us to come and pick up, which is what you're seeing if you're watching, and which makes us look semi-official. And we brought it home. And I don't know about you, but I remember the day that we had to go to the office. This was like about 2 weeks after we broke for a while. This was 2 weeks of staying at home. Nobody knew what was going to happen. And then we were told to go pick up your microphone at the office. And I drove with gloves and Lysol wipes, a mask on in the car.
Yeah.
I popped my trunk for Qua to put the microphone in. I like cracked my window just a little and I gave a wave, you know, like I was so scared to see a human being outside of my own house. And then I came home and then completely disinfected everything with wipes going, this is not okay to touch. And so,
yeah, it's human nature. It's funny how you go from like that extreme to now it's, you know, I mean, I'm still careful, but I'm walking outside and I'm waving to neighbors and I'm just like, how you doing? I'll talk to somebody as long as they're 6 feet away.
That's,
you know,
right.
I guess, you know, you try to, you need some kind of semblance of like normalcy at the end of the day. It's funny that you say that though. I remember before we actually did pick up the microphones, we didn't have yet a plan in place. And I remember that Mark was like, okay, let's just improvise. Maybe go into a closet with your iPhone, or he said a quiet place with your iPhone. And I'm like, well, I live with a 3-year-old and my house is like never quiet. Where can I go? I was like huddled in my closet, like a weirdo with my phone. And obviously the audio was not what it is, you know, using these mics, but I mean, it was one way of trying to get through it. And then, like you said, I went out that day geared up as if I was going to war against this invisible virus. And same thing. Just a little bit of a roll down of a window, waved to Qua, barely spoke, and went home.
I know. And then you feel like you've just been through something when you get home.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, so exactly.
I think we've gotten better at it. Like, we're still taking the precautions that we need to, but we're just getting more used to it, and it's just becoming normal to see people. And
the new normal,
leave the house, you know? So
yes.
But it's like the perfect phrase of like, the show must go on. here we are. We're home. You're in your gaming chair, which I love.
I know.
You're constantly, it looks like you're this gamer. I love it.
And my Yankee hat, you know.
And your Yankee hat, yeah. You know. And, yes. And here we are. We're continuing. And we've got so many more episodes coming.
We will be back.
We will be back. And it's been a great season. It has. Any memorable moments that you can think about?
You know, I have to say, I mean, I obviously, like I was saying earlier, I took something away from every single guest that we've had on the show. It was nice to have those different perspectives. We don't really get that a lot. You know, we're experts specifically in what we discuss all day.
That's right.
So that was that. I loved having that opportunity in general on the show. I specifically, since I am a musician, what was really interesting for me was having, having that opportunity to speak with Jamie when we spoke about, you know, sort of what goes into the DJ industry, and having him sit down with us and really, I mean, he's been in the industry for a really long time now. So
yeah.
I was particularly intrigued with kind of all the information he was giving us. You know, I never really, I didn't know anything about a DJ. All I know is that I want a good one. I want to dance and to understand, you know, the dynamics and what goes on behind it, was really insightful for me. So for having the opportunity to listen to him and be on that episode was a great way to kind of expand my own knowledge on the topic, you know?
Yeah, I love that. I agree. I learned so much and things that we thought that we knew just by the different team that we have put in place. It was great to hear somebody talk about their experience.
Yeah.
Same thing with Carlos. Like, you know, we think we understand photography. Yeah. And just hearing things from Carlos's perspective and, you know, timing things. And one takeaway that I took from his episode, Carlos is one of our photographers here at LPS, and he did one of the episodes with us as a guest. And so one of the takeaways was that he explained that for couples that are missing their cocktail hour, in rather than do a first look and then they end up shooting through the cocktail hour, that's 20% of your wedding. And that put everything into perspective. And I've passed that along to so many couples that I've spoken to since. And I think every single one of them has gone, oh, okay. I don't know if 20% of our wedding is,
and
worth
it is.
Not doing a first
yeah.
look. You know,
that's a really good point. It, you know, it's one thing to just like study photography or study a topic. But when you actually speak to somebody that's living it, you know, I mean, it's just like, when my brother told me, my mom was saying this too, you know, when she got out of nursing school, she's like, you know, I had a degree, I was studying for years. I didn't know what I was doing until I was actually doing it. So actually speaking to her about that, you know, living her experiences, speaking to all of these guests, understanding what they go through on the field when they're taking their pictures, when they're facilitating the music, when they're setting up the room, the flowers, the invitations. I mean, it's a totally different world.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And remember, what was her name from Marquee Floral? Oh, Kim. Yeah.
Kim Lovett. Yes.
Kim. So
she
was great because I remembered what
she was like
said
a ball
like,
of sunshine.
A ball of sunshine, but like a woman, a female like entrepreneur started this.
Yeah.
Like she had kids. Amazing. And had to figure out like some sort of business that she could do to feed her family. And here we are like 20 years later, she's been doing this. So she was totally inspiring in that regard. Also being a working mom, just like you. But then I remembered her saying, and this is coming from somebody who didn't put any effort into flowers in my own wedding, and we've talked about that, but
yeah,
that aha moment. She said, when you open the doors and you have that moment of like the lighting and the music and the flowers are all together and it like takes your breath away. That has completely changed my like view of flowers and also lighting and just that the full ambiance of mm-hmm. what's going on. So
how it sets the tone completely.
Another highlight was Daniel Mariana and the officiant. So something that came up with both of those episodes were taking the heat and the pressure and the focus off of the wedding planning and way more on the marriage, which is so important, you know? I mean, that's so trite to say. But, you know, focusing on the marriage and the officiant that we had on in our last episode, he was great. Just like doing the work.
C- kind of piggybacking off that, when we spoke to Amanda Hughes, I took a little bit away from that as well. I never had hired an event planner. Mm-hmm. But I do know, planning my own wedding and speaking to so many couples, that, you know, it does create a certain amount of tension and stress, and there is fighting sometimes, kind of trying to get through those months that lead up to the big day, because everything's expensive, and who's you know, putting the invitations together. There's a lot of conversations that come up, and when we spoke with Amanda, she kind of just said, I'm a person that can really just take that away, take those stresses away.
That's exactly right.
And I said, oh, okay, there's a ton of value in that.
Imagine there, right now, like, having to reschedule everything, like how that would come into handy.
Oh, my God. I mean, you know, you are doing the work of what they do. And, I mean, she's unbelievable. So kind of when she said that, it really hit home for me. I wish I would have done that myself, you know, because it's just another way to sit back and you, something else you don't have, a huge part of your wedding you don't have to worry about, the planning part of it. Someone does that for you. So now all you can do is enjoy, spend the months enjoying and looking forward to it. So yeah, there was a lot of value in that for me as to why to hire an event planner.
Yep. I know, if we could do it over again.
Yes. You know? 2020.
We had a lot of fun. Even the baker, like the wedding cakes that we had on, she was great. Like, you know, I made a cake actually 2 days ago for my husband's birthday.
And you made a cake?
I made a cake. I made my own icing and cake. And I happened to have sprinkles. I don't know how old the sprinkles are, but we're still living. Like, I put sprinkles on the top.
Did you take a picture?
There's half of it left, so I'll take a picture. I actually put those little – have you ever been out to a restaurant and they put those, like, little paper umbrellas in a drink, like frou-frou? Yeah. Okay, so I happen to have a bag of those, and I put those at the top of the cake because when I put the saran wrap over to cover it, I didn't want it to go on the icing.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So I put those on, and so it's very girly.
Very, very, very innovative, very girly.
It's very girly. It's full of umbrellas and sprinkles.
How cute.
But it's chocolate. It's good. It's very moist.
I'm sure Frank didn't mind, as long as it was chocolate, right?
He loved it. Yeah. Tristan said it was the best cake he's ever had. I'm like, aww. Settle down. I don't know about that.
That's so sweet.
Yeah. So, gosh, anything else you think?
I mean, I just, you know, again, I can't thank the crew enough. You know, the producers, the editors. I mean, everyone. I know you guys see our faces, but there's just a whole team that has been involved with, you know, bringing this podcast to fruition each and every time, and their talent and their expertise, you know, really lends itself to what this is. And I'm really grateful to have such an awesome team. Mark, Nicole, you know, Natalia,
Marcia,
you know, so it's for me, it just makes me appreciate more and more, you know, the LPS family as well.
And it brought a layer of fun because we have fun.
Yes, we do. And like, it's a nice break, you know?
So like all the content that we talk about, that's all put together from production. They think of the episodes, they find the guests. And not only that, they put together like a full format on a drive document of the questions ahead of time, so that the guest has an idea of what they'll be asked and prompted. So it's all on a Google Drive. But the cool thing is as we're doing these podcasts, the drive is live, so many people can edit it at once, and they'll say, you know, like, highlight the questions that we've gotten through, highlight or make bold the ones that we still need to remember.
Oh my God,
do.
It's such a help. Because if it wasn't for them, Natasha and I we right now would probably still be talking about her cake.
Completely. Like, just go on and on forever. Yeah. And then all of a sudden it'll be like, wrap it up. So it's great. They're listening. Like, they keep the flow going. And
that's right.
You know,
that's right.
You and I are like, we're like complete peons and all of this. So.
Well, it's kind of like, I mean, these are our phone conversations. I mean, granted, this whole COVID situation has left us in a state where we can't call each other all day long because husbands are home now and kids.
I know.
But yeah, it's just a reflection of our phone calls. So you guys have been invited into, you know, the crazy world of Natasha and Jean, but now mixed a nice script from our producers. It helps us stay on point.
That's right. And we're so busy with splitting weddings too. So for any couples that are listening and thinking of splitting your wedding, like doing a ceremony now or doing a reception later, it's way more complicated than you think it is. It's not so easy saying like, oh, we'll do our ceremony and then later we'll do everything else. And in a perfect world, and if I were a bride or a groom, I would think it would be so easy to do. Just like, why not? It's just not. It's production wise, it's very complicated. So just hang in there and be patient with us, because it is a I don't want to say it's a mess, but there's a lot of moving parts that have to be.
Yeah. Aligned. Sometimes a whole day will be spent on one contract restructure or two.
That's right.
So to make it right for the couple and exactly what they need it to be, and for the crew as well, to make everything kind of come together and make it make sense. So thank you guys, because we've had many of you for your patience. With us as we navigate through that, because this is all new. But I just want to say thank you to all the listeners. We thanked our team, the listeners, the guests, and I really am excited for the future, because we do, like Natasha said, we have a lot more content to discuss, many more guests that are going to be coming onto the show. And
write us too.
Yeah.
Please. And our email, podcast.livepicturestudios.com. Send us your ideas for, we do have the first few lined up, but, we have a whole season to discuss. So please send us your ideas, and we can't wait.
And other surprises.
Anyway, thank you so much for listening.
Thank you, guys.
Until
the best.
Next time, happy planning. And
Stay safe, stay well, enjoy the summer. And we will see you in September.
Wear your masks.
Yes. Bye, guys.